mentioned just now in his argument that students are discriminated in schools. Do you have an exact number? How do you know it's a majority? Furthermore, you said many parents. Do you have an exact number still? The opposition here requires a definite value if you want to effectively prove your point. Hence, the information provided by the proposition is insufficient. The third speaker has mentioned just now that how do we know divorces is due to racism and racial discrimination? I'd like to add on to the points said by my second speaker just now. Is it proof that divorces are not due to other reasons, or is it just the proposition's own imagination that divorces are due to racial discrimination? Hence, the proposition's argument is insufficiently proved. Furthermore, the third speaker has also mentioned that racial discrimination is present in the world because of a few cases and a few individuals. By doing so, the proposition suggests that the motion means racial harmony is not present due to a few cases. This provides a restrictive debate and does not leave the opposition any room to argue. Hence, in retrospect, the majority of the world is currently living in racial harmony. As seen from examples of USA, Europe and Australia, the people have shown us that they, together with their governments, are currently living in racial harmony. Furthermore, the fact that a proposition is able to work together even though they contain different races already proves that racial harmony is relevant in the world today. In USA, as mentioned by my first speaker, we can see how effective and strong the multiracial society is through policies and laws created by governments alongside the ideas of the people. Similarly, my second speaker has mentioned Europe, which assures that through racial equality, a racially harmonious society is created through equal opportunities for all racial groups, such as having a black manager in the Premier League. My third speaker has brought up Australia and how it has showed us that racial harmony is fostered through the building of trust and friendship among races, like the programs of Uniting Church. The examples the opposition has cited and our explanation of how racial harmony is not a baseless argument. From USA to Europe and even Australia, we have shown you the prevalence of racial harmony in the lives of people. Derailing an incident totally is difficult, if not impossible, because you are dealing with people's mindsets and emotions, which have been accumulated through the years of misconceptions. However, we must try to lessen the racist attitudes through education and information. This will help people understand more about other races, religions, cultures and beliefs. Through the building of trust, friendship and mutual understanding, it is possible to create a tolerant country free from racial discrimination. In societies that are more thoughtful and approve of multiracialism, it seems that racial harmony has already begun and is already happening in the world today. Hence, the opposition has concluded that racial harmony is not just a dream. Racial harmony is a reality. We are all brothers regardless of race, colour or tradition. We are all children of the same Heavenly Father. We rise or we fall together. Thank you.